Hello, people. Welcome to the Duck Farmers Academy. My name is Kennedy, a Ghanaian poultry farmer and also a U.S. Navy veteran. I just want to take this opportunity to thank you and appreciate your time for being here. And I say, God richly bless you. And today too, if you're new to this channel, I know you're going to benefit. And if you're always being here, thank you so much. And if you find this content to be so helpful to you, you can just hit the notification button and subscription button. Subscribe to this channel and let's try to build this family, a quality family, because we are learning to help build the poultry industry in Ghana. Thank you so much. And today, what are we talking about here? I've been receiving a lot of calls and messages that people are selling their birds, and they've been calling me to receive advice or to give them advice. And I think it's very nice for me to come here and share what I'm telling them with you, for things that I think is going wrong and the thing that we can do to survive in this kind of hardship that we are going through. So today the video is why people are selling their poultry birds. Why people are selling their poultry birds and what we need to do. So if you're a new guy or if you're a new investor or entrepreneur who is going to Ghana and going to poultry farming, basically in any part of Africa, and you want to start farming, just want you to know these things before you go in. And if you're about to sell your birds, these are the things I want to encourage you to just do so that things will be okay for you. You know, the sun has started coming. So so now, what is causing all this bird selling, or people are selling their birds? What is causing all that? One is unexpected increase of mates. You cannot say you are blaming the poultry farmers or you are blaming them, because we have had an increase in maize, even though it happens every year, but this one has been really a kind of a higher, because mostly every year it's increased in the same way, but this one has been like a little bit overboard. Let me use that word a little bit, you know, just need a little bit overboard. So that has caused a lot of people moving from the poultry industry. That is causing people to sell their birds and like, oh, I'm out of the poultry, or I'm out. So that is one of the things that is causing them. What else again is causing? So I'm trying to tell you what is causing people to sell all these birds that they are telling you, to I'm selling my birds. That is the causes. So if you are also getting to know the problems, you know what to do. So another one is, I won't say that, but let me tell you, that is also part of it. Unplanned poultry starting. If you are starting poultry farming, let me tell you one thing about it. If you are starting poultry farming, one thing I will encourage you, then if you buy 1,000 birds, or if you are starting 2,000 birds, you must have a double money. Let's say I'm starting poultry farm with 1,000 birds, and the 1,000 birds is costing me 9,000, maybe 9,500, 9,600 in Ghana cities. In dollars, it's like maybe 1,000, let's say 1,500. You must have 2 times or 3 times of the money that you use to start the poultry to be able to feed them. Okay, to be able to feed them. Otherwise, you're gonna stuck, because buying the birds alone is easy. I'm not saying it's easy money, but caring for the birds is very hard, because by the time the birds start laying, every bird is going to cost almost 35 Ghana cedis. In dollars, it's going to be like $15 or not $15, I think $8 for every bird. So before you go in, make sure the money you are going to use to rear the birds, it's like 2 times or almost more than 2 times the money you bought the birds. Otherwise, you're going to be stuck with it. So if you're buying 10,000 birds, make sure you having that money. Let's say I'm buying 2,000 birds, which is going to cost me, let's say, let's use the example for 5,000 birds. 5,000 birds, let's say, it's costing me like $8,000. Make sure you have about maybe $16,000 or $20,000 before you can raise that 8,000 birds. Otherwise, when maize price increase, like what we are going now, or anything happens, you're gonna be going down. So it's very important to go. That's why I'm stressing on that point. Very, very important. And that is costing most people, because they started with 1,000 bears. Oh, I have only this amount. No, you must have double money of the best that you are going for before you can raise them. And the next one is why people are selling their best. The next one is price of eggs not catching up with their feed. So now it's like, if you consider the feed, a ton of feed, if you make 1,000 kilos of feed, it's ranging from 2,800, or let me say 2,500, all the way to 3,000, depending on the feed that you use. So a lot of people are also running at a loss. And if they sell eggs, if you sell eggs for 12 cities, 13 cities, 14 cities, you're not going to make that money for 1,000, even let's use 1,000 bears as our case study. If you do that, you're going to run at a loss. If you sell eggs below 14 cities, you are running at a loss. Yes, I know for sure. So that is why, that is one of the reasons people are also selling their bears. So one is unexpected maize increase. Two is unplanned starting, you do it anyhow. Three is price of eggs not catching up with feed, which is also, I'm not going to leave you like that. I'm going to give you the solutions of how you can be able to survive these seasons. I'll just let you know, because I've moved through before. So I want you to succeed. I don't want you to run away from, not running away, to quit. Now, at times it's good to quit, but at times you have to endure too. The next one is laying going down. Especially most of these farmers who having problem with their laying. When it comes to this season, most bears suffer CLD. Do you know CLD? I'll tell you. Do you want me to tell you? Let's go. It's chronic respiratory diseases, CLD, and Newcastle. And when these diseases happen in the bears, production goes down. Most of them, especially Newcastle. It will even kill some of the bears, production going down drastically. So most of these people also go in the same problem, because they are not able to buy good medication, because the money is not there. They are not able to feed them right. So Coxie, Newcastle, and down, their production starts to decrease. So if production is decreasing and your feed is not also going up, your production is not going up, what is the result? Now you happen to be running at a loss. So people, this is one of the reason also people selling their bears, because diseases is catching their bears, and another day they are not getting to anywhere, and they have to do that. And the last one that I'll say is too much loans. People went for loans to start their business. So now if you went for loan and the banks or the person, maybe it's a personal loan that you went for a friend or somebody, and it's chasing you for the loan. Now, if you don't have any job doing or any backup, you try to sell their best to just get yourself out of that troubles. So people, these are some of the reasons people sell their best. So now, do we blame them? No, it's a business, things happen. And I know that you don't have to blame them. It can happen to me, it can happen to you. So now, what do we need to learn? That's why I'm saying, this page, we are here to help you learn, help you own your own business, and motivate you. That's why I say, it's good to be part of this family, and let's build together. Now, what do you have to do? Now, all this problem that we are going through, maize, diseases, these productions, things are going to be normal, especially in December, starting from August ending going on September. Why am I saying that? Because maize prices are going to go a little bit down for you. So you'll be in September, you'll be able to have a very nice maize prices. So if you're buying maize like almost 3.5 now, or 3.6 or whatever prices, let's say $80 or $70 per bag, for 130 kilos, in September you're gonna go back to maybe, let's say, $50 or $40. Like in Ghana cities, it's gonna go like a little bit down, like let's say 2 million 200 Ghana cities, or maybe 250 Ghana cities thereabout. So you know the price is gonna come down. So if you can hold on and not sell the best to September, things are going to be all right. Trust me, things are going to be all right. You're not going to get out of maybe the cost that the losses that you have incurred for the longer time. Everything is going to be one away off, but it's going to come down a little bit for you. The next one is, you can, for now, a little bit thing that you can do, switch from your own, if you prepare your own feed and it's costing you, especially using the maize, switch from that one, go to pre-made feed. I know people have been mentioning this feed, Sankofa, so much. Sankofa, I don't really use it. I've never used it before, but I know people use it. And they say one bag is, I think, 127, 128 Ghana cedis. Let me do a promotion for them because I want to help you. Not like maybe anything. So you can also try that one. Because if you use 127 as a feed, then that means a ton is getting to 1,500 and something. That is also very good. In dollars, it's kind of, is it like $600 or $700, something like that, a ton of feed. Yeah, so it'll be good for you. So if you're in any country and you see you're facing this one, switch, you can switch the feed and see which one. But don't switch feed and go for low quality, because that one will come back and hunt you, because it will decrease the production. As I always tell you, I did one time and it just didn't help me. But I know Sankofa, people have been mentioning that feed and it's helping them. The next one, seek for partnership. Maybe you are an individual who started poultry farming, you're a young guy, or you're in a foreign country, anything, things are not going under, loans, things are burdening you, seek for partnership. Somebody come in with a partnership. Maybe you started with a poultry farming, it's costing you about $2,000, $10,000, $5,000, $80,000. Ask somebody, do you want to come in? Maybe bring $30,000 in. Maybe bring $10,000 in. I'll give you 50% of the business. And now you can use that money to cater form of the loans and the cost that you have incurred. And the person will come in, or different, based on different times you go with the person, come in, let's settle the loans, and now you become part of the company. Or bring me money in, I'll give you, what's the name, bond, I give you maybe every month, I give you maybe $200, every month I give you $100 in, so that the business, I can run it smoothly, and the person also gets some money, and you can also have some money to run the business. And the next one is, what I was saying, have 2x money before you start a business, that it will be good for you. 2x the money that you went for the bears. If you went for 2,000 bears, multiply that money 2x before you're able to raise the bears. If it becomes a surplus, you gain your money. So people, these are the tips I want to share with you today. And as I always say, chase your dreams and money will follow you. Okay? And to meet next time. And if today is your first year, please subscribe. Don't forget that one. I'm so happy that you're gonna subscribe and you'll be part of the family. Thank you so much that our numbers are building. Till we meet next time, chase your dreams and money will follow you. Peace. Shalom.